Welcome students to the commerce class. I welcome you all once again. Now we have completed the fourth lesson, fourth chapter, and before moving to the fifth chapter, we have to see the difference between the primary market and the secondary market. So we'll see the difference between the primary market and secondary market. Students, you can see a picture over here. So it states the difference between a primary market and secondary market. Before going into the difference between the primary market and secondary market, I want you to see this picture. Look at this picture. So here a company is there in primary market. A company is there and the company gives a share to a person. So how he becomes a shareholder? He gives a money and gets a share from a company. So the company sells to the investor. So he is a investor. The company sells. That means some part of company shares is given to that person in his name. But whereas you see in the secondary market is not like that. The shares are went to the stock exchange. So the investor sells the shares to the stock exchange. And in stock exchange, in return, another investor's spends his money to get that share from that person is through the stock exchange. So this is the investor sells to investor. So to understand, company sells to investor is a primary market, and in secondary market, the investors sells to the investors. Now we'll see the difference between the new issue market and the secondary market. So for the basis of comparison, we have meaning. The first one is meaning. Meaning in new issue market says the market is a place for new shares is called a primary market. So the new issue of shares, the new issue of shares in a market is a primary market. So new issue market is also known as the primary market. And in secondary market, its meaning is the place where formally issued securities are traded is known as the secondary market. Okay. And the next one is buying. Buying is done in new issue market directly. So I told you all in primary market before, so I showed you all the picture. Okay. A picture I showed you all in the screen. In the last screen itself you have seen. So it shows that it is a direct buying, whereas in secondary market it is indirect. So they doesn't know the buyer and the seller here. The next one is financing. So it supplies fund to budding enterprises. What do you mean by budding enterprises? Budding enterprises means it is the starting of a company, any starting company. So budding enterprises, and also to the existing companies. Existing companies is before itself the company is there. It is for maybe 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 years before itself the company is in existence for expansion and diversification. So that means for the expansion of the company, for the budding company, starting company also they are giving the money. So whereas in secondary market it does not provide funding to companies. They doesn't provide a fund to the companies. Keep in mind. Okay, the next one is how can securities be sold? In new issue market, that is in primary market, only once the security is shown, but sold. But whereas in secondary market, the multiple times the securities can be sold. But in new issue market, that is in primary market, only one time you can sell the securities. But in secondary market, it can be multiple times. Buying and selling between in primary market companies and investors. I told you company to investors. But whereas in secondary market the buying and selling is done between investors to investors. Okay. The next one is gained person. Who is the gained person here in primary market? It is a company. But where it is in secondary market, who is the gained person? Investors. Next one is intermediary. So in primary market the underwriters, and in secondary market the brokers who work in between the investors and investors. Okay. The next one is price. In primary market it is a fixed price, whereas in secondary market fluctuates depends upon the demand and supply force. So it depends on the demand and supply force according to it. So it can be changing. Fluctuate means it changes. It doesn't fix the price. So in primary market the price is fixed, whereas in secondary market it fluctuates. The next one is organizational differences. What is the organizational difference here? Not rooted to any specific or specific spot or geographical location. So there is no specification. So there is no geographical location here. You have to go there. The organization must be here. Then only we will provide something, funds and all. There is no specifications in there. But whereas in secondary market, it has physical existence. That means the person is physically existence. We are getting any information that the person is physically is existence. So they can provide on. So the organizational differences both itself there is no in the company side. Okay. So in somehow in secondary market we are not going to provide or buy or sell anything to the companies. We are going to only go on with the investors. Whereas in the primary market we are going to deal with the company and the investors. Okay. The persons and the companies. So keep in mind. So students, we have completed all these things. What we have completed in finance, financial market, what and all we have seen. We have seen its meaning, definition, and next is functions and role of financial markets and the difference between financial markets, that is new issue market and secondary market. And we have seen the functions also, two types. So listen, now we have completed the fourth chapter, that is the fourth lesson in financial markets 1, introduction to. Next we move on to the fifth chapter, that is capital market, under financial markets 1, the second unit under that fifth chapter, that is fifth lesson, capital market. So here we are going to see about the meaning and definition, characteristics of capital markets and the kinds of capital markets. Before that, we are going to learn about the meanings and definitions. Next is characteristics of capital market. And next is kinds of capital market. So, now we are going to go on with the capital market. Before moving on to the meaning of capital market, first we want to know what is capital. Capital means it is an investment. That is a starting investment what we are investing in a company. To start a company, starting amount of investment. So here we are moving on to the meaning of capital market. So the meaning of capital market, the term capital market refers to the facilities and institutional arrangements through which long-term funds, both debt and equity, are raised and invested. So I told you before itself, capital means an investment which is made. So it consists of a series of channels through which savings of the community are made available for industrial and commercial enterprises. What? Industrial and commercial enterprises and for the public in general. So the term capital markets refers us about the long-term funds, what they are investing to raise the company's profit. Okay. So next, listen students, it directs these savings into their most productive use, leading to the growth and development of the economy. So if the company gets invested with the amount, if the company gets the profit, so also the economy, the growth of the economy is also is developed. So the capital market consists of development banks, commercial banks and stock exchanges. So an ideal capital market is one where finance is available at reasonable cost. So the process of economic development is facilitated by the existence of well-functioning capital market. Normally we know what is market. Market is a place where the buyer and the seller meets. But here in capital market is a market where buyers and sellers engage in trade of financial securities
of financial securities like bonds and stocks. So here the market takes place between a buyer and a seller. For what? To sell the securities and bonds and stocks. So the buying and selling process here undertakes or undertaken by the participants such as individuals and institutions. So an individual person can sell this stocks or bonds, same as like that an institution also. So the capital market forms an important core of a country's financial system. So the process of the economic development is facilitated by the existence of well as the functions of a markets.
Next is the definition of the capital market. So the capital market can be defined as a market for borrowing and lending of long-term capital funds required by business enterprises. So a market for borrowing and lending of long-term capital funds. So it is not a short-term fund, it is a long-term capital fund. So lending and borrowing, okay, long-term capital funds required by business enterprise. So what the enterprise, business enterprise means the company or the industry, what the enterprise, what the business needs. So the capital market offers an ideal source of external finance. So what is the ideal market here? Then ideal capital market is a one where finance is analyzed of its availability at a responsible at a frequent time. So it's an ideal market. So where we get the finance availabilities at a reasonable list of price. So next is, it is the capital, it refers to all the facilities and the institutional arrangements for borrowing and lending. So borrowing and lending, so buying and selling is over here. Borrowing and lending, medium term and long term funds. So long term funds and short term funds, like anyway. So medium and long term funds and short term funds. Short term funds. Like any market, the capital market is also composed of those who demand funds, that is the borrowers, and those who supply funds, that is known as the lenders. Okay. So next, this is the definition given. We see according to the author. Here, according to Arun K. Datta, the capital market may be defined as a complex of institutions, investment and practices with established links between the demand for and supply of different types of capital gains. Okay, so here the author says a complex of institutions, investment. So investment is a capital. Investment and practices with established links between the demand for and supply of different types of capital gains. So these are all the definitions given by the authors of capital market. Next we move on to the characteristics of capital market. So we have seen what is market, what is capital market, what is the meaning and definition of it according to the given authors, and now we are going to see the characteristics of capital market. Under that you have 5 points. One is securities market, price, participants, location, market and financial assets. So first is securities market. Securities market, the dealings in a capital market are done through the securities. So in capital market, the dealings are done through securities. So the buying and sellings are done through the securities like shares, debentures, etc. So the capital market is also called a security market. So now the security market means capital market is also called as a security market. Next is price. The price of a securities is determined based on the demand and supply prevailing in the capital market for securities. So the price is determined according to the securities.
Next is participants. There are many players in the capital market. So, the participants of a capital market include individuals, corporate sectors, governments and banks, other financial institutions. So, next is location. So, the participants, we have seen what is security market. So, capital market is also known as a security market. And next is what is the price is determined. And next we saw the participants. So, those who are going to participate in it, the individual will participate in this market. And next is corporate sectors, government also. And financial institutions, other financial institutions. Okay, next is location. So, capital market is not confined to certain specific location. There is no certain location like we are going to buy some vegetables or fruits. We are going to buy to go to the shop and get it. Here, there is no location like that. So, although it is true that parts of the market are concentrated in certain well-known centers known as stock exchange. So, we know that we have only stock exchange places. So, it is as its impact in the overall economy, wherever suppliers and users of capital get together to do business. So, if the business, if they want to share or sell their securities, sell their shares and bonds, so in that place they can do the capital market also. So, next one is market for financial assets. So, capital markets provides a transaction platform for long-term financial assets. Next, we see about the new topic, that is kinds of capital market. There are two kinds of capital market. One is primary market, another one is secondary market. So, here we are going to see the different types of or kinds of capital market. So, the capital market is divided into two parts, that is primary market and secondary market, as it's shown here. So, first is primary market. And the primary market is a market of new issues or new financial claims. Hence, it is also called a new issue market. So, it is also called a new issue market. So, the primary market deals with those securities which are issued to the public for the first time. So, the first time they are issuing it. In the primary market, borrowers exchange new facilities, new financial securities for a long-term fund. Borrowers exchange the new financial securities for a long-term funds. So, the primary market facilitates the capital formations. So, next we move on to the secondary market. So, primary market is for the first time. Secondary market may be defined as a market for old securities. So, it is a second hand in the sense that securities which are previously issued in the primary market are traded here. So, before itself, first time they were issued in the primary market. After that, they are selling it again in the secondary market. So, the trading takes place between the investors who follow the original issue in the primary market. So, it covers both stock exchange and over-the-counter market. Okay, students, now you can see the kinds of capital market. Here, a diagram shows that it is a types of capital market, same. So, under that, you have two types. I told you all before itself, primary market and secondary market. And the primary market, public issue, right issue and bonus issue. Public issue, right issue and bonus issue or private placement. Okay. So, next, under secondary market, it is a stock market. Okay. So, under primary market, that is public issue, right issue, bonus issue, private placement. So, now let us see the three ways by which a company may raise capital in a primary market. So, through primary market, how the bonds or shares are sold in the capital market. How they can raise their company's profit or company's gain. First one is public issue. And a public issue, the most common method of raising capital by new companies is through sale of securities of the public. It is called a public issue. So, The most common method of raising capital is by selling the new companies is through sale of securities to the public. Next one is right issue. So when an existing company wants to raise additional capital, that is the company which has been before itself. But in public issue, we saw about the new companies, that is budding company, I told you all before itself. So budding companies, but here it is a new company. But in right of issue, it is an old company, that is existing company, wants to raise the additional capital. Securities are first offered to the existing shareholders on a pre-emptive basis. That is before itself in primary issue, in the first time itself they have been issued before itself when the company has started. After that, in the additional, that is additional capital means if they want the company to growth, company's growth or company's benefit or company's gain. So in that time they offer the securities to the shareholders. So it is a pre-emptive basis, that is a right issue. Next one is private placement. Private placement is a way of selling securities privately to a small group of investors, not to a big group, to a small group of investors. So these are all the things which increases the capital of a company through the primary market, how they are selling it. So secondary market, stock market, that we have seen. Secondary market that they have seen before itself, so that is a stock exchange. So stock exchange means both. It is a National Stock Exchange and a Bombay Stock Exchange. So in India we are going to see about the Bombay Stock Exchange, and overall we will see about the National Stock Exchange. So now we have completed till the kinds of capital market. So go through it, student. Thank you.